Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Thursday, March 13th, 2014. We're coming up to 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are higher. Dow futures currently up about 30 points. Energy futures mixed with crude oil higher, natural gas slightly lower, and gold is up once again in the pre-market this morning. Let's start off this morning taking a look at our commodity ETFs. Let's start off by looking at the metals, and copper has seen some panic selling over the last couple of days. Yesterday it actually closed higher, but didn't really eat into Tuesday's big decline. So the first sign that something new is happening is a daily close above Tuesday's high. Notice that we're far away from the channel lines, and we've also got a nice big open gap there that could potentially act as not only a price target on the way up, but a resistance. Looking at our price targets, we're trading below what was support, 35.94. And so if we can't get above that on Thursday, then we're looking for a move down to 34.38 as our next potential area of support. Now, in the other direction, we've got gold moving higher, so now we're seeing some panic buying in gold. We're above the October highs, and we're going to open higher this morning. We're above resistance at 131.25. If we can hold that, then 134.38 is our next target to the upside. Platinum had a wild day on Tuesday, traded right down to the lower channel line and then came back. Yesterday was an inside day for platinum, still above the upper channel line, so we're looking to see if we can take out the recent high on Thursday. And then silver's starting to look good. We traded back into the channel yesterday, traded through the upper channel line but didn't hold it. So a close above a 20.54 would give us a buy signal for silver on Thursday. Next up, let's take a look at energy, and crude oil continued to move lower yesterday, opening up a gap. It's up in the pre-market this morning. Looking at our price targets, we ran up and hit 37.50, so hopefully you've got orders filled up there. We were looking to find support at 35.94. That didn't hold, so we're trading lower. We're up in the pre-market this morning, but not enough to fill that open gap. So potentially our next target to the downside here is $34.38. Now, when we look at gasoline and natural gas, they're basically treading water at the moment. We're looking for a close above 60.01 to give us a buy signal for gasoline. And for natural gas, we're looking for a close above $25.86 on Thursday. Next up, let's take a look at those pieces of the puzzle. Just looking at the pieces of the puzzle, you really have a very cloudy picture here. We had the VIX trade through the upper channel line yesterday. It didn't hold the gains, but if we close above 14.94 on Thursday, that would give us a buy signal. And of course, the fear index is not, when it's rising, it's not supportive for higher stock prices. So right now we're in the channel. That's the neutral zone. We've also got the bonds in the channel, so they're in the neutral zone as well. Now, if bonds are trending higher, that's not usually good for stocks. If they're trending lower, that's supportive for higher stock prices. And if they're trading sideways, that really doesn't matter much. So it looks like bonds are getting ready to trend higher, and that might not be good for stock prices. So a close above yesterday's high would give us a buy signal for the 30-year bond. Looking at the Japanese yen, now if you've been with us a while, you know that for the longest time we watched the relationship between the euro and the U.S. dollar. But last year that changed. It's changed several times over the past decade. But last year they were borrowing money in Japanese yen and then buying U.S. stocks with it. And so when you've got the yen going lower, that's supportive for higher stock prices. When you've got the yen going higher, that's negative for stock prices. And so we've had the yen going higher the last couple of days. It is back in the channel, so that's the neutral zone. So it's a pretty foggy picture right now. And the U.S. dollar still trending lower, no change in trend there. So the pieces of the puzzle, it's not a negative picture, but it's certainly not an overly bullish picture either. And so we don't have any trend changes here. We don't have any action to take on Thursday morning. Next up, let's take a look at our daily index charts. Now, of the major indexes that I follow, we had one trend change yesterday, but we also had a lot of close calls. Both the Dow and the S&P 500 traded down to the lower channel line, but did not close below it. In fact, they closed higher on the day, so we had a lot of reversals yesterday, but a lot of close calls. We had the NASDAQ 100, the Russell 2000, and the ZACS Microcap All trade below the lower channel line, but recovered going into the close and closed higher on the day. So a lot of close calls yesterday. We saw bank stocks trade back into the channel, but ended the day above, closing above the upper channel line. We had credit card stocks in the channel yesterday. We had energy stocks in the channel. We saw some strength for copper stocks, but again, just like copper itself, we didn't take out the previous day's high, so no real change there. We saw fertilizer stocks trade through the lower channel line, but closed above it, so in the channel for the close on Wednesday for fertilizer stocks. The XAU, gold and silver stocks, reversed and gave us a buy signal. And so we're looking to take out those recent highs, and we're hoping that all gold and silver stocks will eventually close above and trade above their October highs. Looking at home construction, continued to move lower yesterday. We saw a little strength in semiconductors. Again, they came down to the lower channel line intraday. Transports came down to the upper channel line and reversed going into the close. And utilities closed in the middle of the channel, so neutral zone for utilities. Let's move on and take a look at some of the NASDAQ's most actively traded stocks, starting with Amazon.com. We're still on a buy signal here, but have not been able to take out the previous week's high. We've got an open gap, and so we're seeing reluctance for traders to trade back into that open gap. It's acting as resistance. A close below 362.35 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. For Apple Computer, we're on our second day of a buy signal. We're stuck between two gaps. The top of this gap is acting as support. The top of this gap is acting as resistance. So we're looking for a breakout of that range. Looking at BlackBerry, BlackBerry's down. It's on its third day of a sell signal. There is support at $9, and so people are looking to see if that level of support holds. Looking at eBay, we're on our second day of a sell signal, traded back into the channel yesterday. Facebook, still holding the lower channel line, a close below 68.94. Would give us a sell signal on Thursday. Looking at Google, we're on our second day of a sell signal as well, traded higher yesterday and closed just above the lower channel line. Looking at Groupon, Groupon's been treading water for a couple of weeks now. No interest in trying to take it back into the open gap. A close above 873 would give us a buy signal on Thursday. I'm always saying the name of the day during the presentation because the numbers we're looking at are good for that day. I don't want people coming back and looking at the presentations later and then seeing that that level is the level that they should be following when it's changed on a daily basis. Just to see how it works. On Monday we were looking for a close on LinkedIn below 201.93. On Tuesday we got that close, and so we closed at 201.50 below the lower channel line. That gave us a sell signal. Both of those numbers are now changing, and so right now we're looking for a close above 208.41 as of Tuesday's close. And on Wednesday's close, now we're looking for a close above 208.14 to give us a buy signal. So like many other stocks, traded up yesterday into the close, but we're still nowhere near a buy signal for LinkedIn as we come in to Thursday morning. And remember, we do everything based on closing prices, so we're not using stops in the market intraday. When you use stops for protection, that of course turns you into a day trader. We certainly use stops for profit targets, but not as safety exits. Looking at Yahoo, we had a nice recovery yesterday. Still closed slightly lower on the day, so we're still on our third day of a sell signal for Yahoo. Looking at Yahoo's on its third day of a sell signal. Had a nice recovery yesterday, but still closed lower on the day. And let's finish off with Zynga, managing to close higher. Had an inside day on Wednesday. A close below 5:30 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. Starting with the VIX for the S&P 500, we had this open gap, which acted as resistance for this move up. And then we had this open gap, which acted as resistance for this move up. And so now we're working ourselves into a triangle here and looking for a breakout of that triangle. Now we still have some other open gaps. There's an open gap up here and an open gap up here that hasn't been filled. But of course those don't come into play until you're heading in that direction. Looking at the S&P 500, it's also working itself into a little corner here. And so we're looking for a breakout or a breakdown of those trend lines. Last week we used the 50-hour moving average as support. That broke down. We got down to the 100-hour moving average. So you're not going to see people's eyes start to bulge out until we start to break down below the 200-hour moving average. Looking two lines up, well, the first line is 1875, then we're back up to 1882, 81. So that's our target prices if we're going to head higher on Thursday. Looking down, I would look down all the way down to the 1843.75. You can see lots of buyers came in at that area, and so that would be a significant target to the downside and certainly a place where the bulls would want to try to defend the market if it started to move lower. But we've got the futures up a couple of points in the pre-market this morning, so there's a potential that at 10:30 this morning we are going to close above 1869.23. If we can do that at 10:30, that would give us a new intraday buy signal and tell us that we're heading up towards the 1875 and then ultimately up to retest the recent highs. Okay, folks, that's all for this morning's presentation. Just looking over my shoulder, I see that the Dow futures have slipped a little. They're up 24 points in the pre-market. Sorry about losing Tuesday. We're a day behind this week. I'll be back tomorrow morning to look at the Canadian market and back on Monday to look at the U.S. market. If I don't talk to you tomorrow, have a great weekend, have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.